So today's social studies, standard 7, we are discussing about the contributions of prominent leaders, prominent African leaders. In our previous lesson, we had looked at Nelson Mandela. And in today's lesson, we are going to cover Gamal Abdel Nasser. So, what do you know about Gamal Abdel Nasser? You raise up your hand. What do you know about Gamal Abdel Nasser? Give to the vet. Cornelius, yes, I can see your hand is up. Cornelius?
He is a trained soldier.
Very good. He was a trained soldier, good boy. What else do you know about Gamal Abdel Nasser? Raise up your hand. Mark Faris. Yes, I can see here. Dominic Gitau, what do you know about Gamal Abdel Nasser?
He was born in Egypt.
Very good boy. He was born in Egypt. Gamal Abdel Nasser, he was born in Egypt at a place called Alexandria. In January 1918. That was during the First World War, in 1918, during the First World War. Then in 1952, Colonel Nasser and General Mohammed, they led a revolution which removed a king called Pharaoh of Egypt from power. Don't write this, I'll give you the notes. Again, Colonel Nasser and General Mohammed, they led a revolution which removed King Farouk. King Farouk was the king of Egypt from that time, or during that time. This is because the government of King Farouk was corrupt and inefficient. So a republic was established in 1953. With the General Mohammed as the president. Then in 1954, Nasser took over as the president of Egypt. Because General Mohammed was not willing to continue with the reforms. So Colonel Nasser carried out the reforms. So, and we have said he took over the seat of the presidency. That means he became the president of Egypt in the year 1954. Again, allow me to take you back behind a bit. We said that Gamal Abdel Nasser, with another leader called Mohammed Naguib, they led a revolution. And this revolution, it was to remove a king of Egypt who was called King Farouk. Farouk is F-A-R-O-U-K. King Farouk of Egypt from power. Why? Because this king, his government was a corrupt government. his government was a corrupt government. Therefore, there was a republic that was established. In 1953, with this General Mohammed as the president. So in 1953, this republic was established and General Mohammed took over as the president. Then in 1954, Colonel Nasser, who is Gamal Abdel Nasser, he took over as the president of Egypt in that 1954. Why? Because General Mohammed had refused. He was not willing to continue with the reforms. So this made Colonel Nasser to take over and carry out the reforms, as we are going to see in some few seconds. So as you can see on your screen, so Gamal Abdel Nasser, you can see on your screen, he was born on 15th of January 1918 at a place called Alexandria in Egypt. He was a trained soldier and he led a revolution which removed King Farouk of Egypt from power and took over as the president of Egypt. McFarris, take us through the contributions of Gamal Abdel Nasser.
He carried out land reforms. He improved working conditions. He abolished Sharia courts. He improved the living standards, e.g. use of birth control and provision of clean water. He encouraged the formation of cooperative societies. Established industries, he planned and completed Aswan High Dam, participated in the formation of OAU, built more schools and universities, he maintained the Suez Canal, and died in 1970, was still the president.
Good boy. So we are saying that Gamal Abdel Nasser, he carried out land reforms, and some of the land was taken away from the rich and given to the poor. So he carried out land reforms. Then also improved the working conditions of workers. Remember, at that time, workers were given better salaries, housing, and retirement benefits through the fight of Gamal Abdel Nasser. He also abolished the Sharia courts and established a modern judicial system. Gamal Abdel Nasser also, he built many schools and more universities, and the system of education was changed to favor industrialization. Remember, industrialization means the growth of towns. Therefore, he allowed free primary education, which he allowed it to be provided. Also, he planned and completed the construction of the Aswan High Dam. Remember when we're looking at the multi-purpose river project, we said that we have another one called Aswan High Dam that is built in Egypt. So he is the one who completed the construction of that dam. And this led to increased production of electricity for the industries in Egypt. So water from Lake Nasser was also used for irrigation, fishing, and also transport, because of the efforts of Gamal Abdel Nasser. Also, he participated in the formation of Organization of African Union. He played an important role in assisting liberation movements in Africa. Remember the other time when we were looking at the struggle for independence in Tanganyika? Let us look at, I want you to remember this before we go to the next prominent leader, who is Leopold Seda Senga. I want you to note that Colonel Nasser, or Gamal Abdel Nasser, he brought to an end an oppressive traditional political system. He brought to an end, means he fought until it ended, the oppressive traditional political system. And he replaced it with a democratic government. Remember, when we're talking about democracy, we are talking about the rule of the people by the people. He helped to improve the living standards of the people of Egypt and also supported the other African countries in their fight for independence. Then we are saying that this boy called Colonel Gamal Abdel Nasser, he died in 1970. So, and say, and remember we said he was born in 1918, therefore he died in 1970. You can now calculate for yourself how many years he lived. So let us look at Leopold Seda Senga. Let us look at Leopold Seda Senga. So Leopold Seda Senga, he was born on 19th October 1906 at a place called Jol in Senegal. And then he completed his studies in poetry and politics in 1931. So he studied for poetry and politics and joined the French army and fought Germans. He joined the French army and fought Germans during the Second World War. So he was captured and released later. Then in 1945, he was elected in the French parliament. And the people of Senegal elected Seda Senga as their representative in the French parliament. Then in 1960, he became president of Senegal. He became the president of Senegal. So when Senegal attained its independence with Leopold Seda Senga, he became the first president. So he ruled Senegal for 20 years and voluntarily retired from politics. We also have another leader who voluntarily retired from politics, and you can remember who was that? Gift Damet?
Nelson Mandela.
Good boy was Nelson Mandela. So he voluntarily retired from politics in 1980. Let us look at his contributions. Dominic, if you can hear me, take us through the contributions.
Contributions of Leopold Senga. He was the greatest writer and poet of Africa. Used poetry to spread culture and values of Africans. Led Senegal in their struggle for independence. Represented people in the French Parliament. First African president to retire voluntarily from active politics. Died on 20th of December 2001 at the age of 95 years.
Wow, at the age of 95 years, that is a long time ago. Then we are also saying he was the first African president to retire voluntarily from active politics. He retired voluntarily from active politics. Then he set a good example for other African leader. Also, Leopold Senga, he led the people of Senegal in the struggle against colonial rule until they attained independence in 1960. In other words, we are saying that he fought for the independence of his country. Then he used poetry to spread information about the importance of African culture and values, and also to encourage Africans to unite. He also used poems to oppose French colonial rule in Senegal. So Leopold Senga was one of the greatest writers in poetry in Africa. He was among the He was among the greatest writers in Africa. The greatest writers of poetry in Africa. And then it is important to note that Leopold Senger, he died on 20th December 2001 at the age of 95 years. How many years did Gabriel Nasser live? For those who calculated, how many years? He was born in 1918 and died in 1970. How many years did he live? Anybody who has calculated, you can side chat me your answer. How many years did he live? John Kimita, I have found your answer. That is correct. 72 years. I have seen your answer. That is correct. So, Elvis, 52 years. That is correct. Wale, 72 years. That is correct. Andrea, 72 years. That is correct. Cornelius Mwangi, 52. Now who is saying the truth? Meru Amboi, 62. Natasha, 72. Okay, let us stop there. Let us stop there. I've seen your answer. Dominic, I've seen your answer. Peace, I've seen your answer. Your answer is there. So let's stop there. So that is all about the contributions of prominent leaders. Remember today, we were looking at Gamal Abdel Nasser and Leopold Seder Senger. Leopold Seder Senger. So that brings us to the end of our lesson for today. That brings us to the end of